They claim 70 plus today. Tide's low in about an hour and a half. I'm headed to the cave. I'm going to share something with you. I don't know that I ever shared it to you, but I'm going to show it to you anyway. I use a 5mm Henderson. It's like I got a gold lining inside of it. I had it a long time. It was a full suit. And I cut the top of it off. So it comes up about just under my, just above my waist about 3 or 4 inches. Here's my waist right along in here. It's that much higher than my waist. And that's all I really need, because I'm not going way out here up to my neck anymore. It's too damn cold. Even though the wetsuit keeps you warm, you got to, your arms are covered up. I just keep my body warm. I wear Henderson 7mm boots. And I find dive boots to be very uncomfortable. So I take these shoe liners that you buy, you heat them up, stick them in the oven for 2 or 3 minutes, and you put them in your shoes and you wear them around. Well, I took these out of my shoes. I got 3 pair of these. And I stick them in my dive boots. It's like walking on pillows. I like them. Anyway, I got to get dressed and hit to the cave. I see you. You know, the guru sewed these straps on for me. Sometimes this thing would slide down, you know, and I had a hell of a time keeping it up. So I got the guru to sew these straps off of my old waders. That's my back of my waders right there. Sewed it right on there like that. And it goes across my shoulders and keeps my suit up. And that's too much information for you. Call the Mumbles man, see if he was going, but he's got a doctor's appointment. He can't make it. So I'm headed alone. I'm sure I won't be alone though, a day like today. I imagine I'd be several, if not many, looters. But you never can tell. Stand by. As we go down the road here, I might as well share some more information with you. Now, it's not the kind of information you're expecting. It's probably too much information for you. But I'm going to share it with you anyway. Now, some people have always asked, why don't you wear a dry suit? Why do you wear a wetsuit? Why don't you wear waders? Well, 10, 12 years ago, I did have a dry suit for about 5 or 6 months. I didn't like it. It was hard to get into. It was cold, even though I had a lot of stuff on underneath of it. And I had to pee once in a while. So then I switched to waders. Now, waders I really liked for the depth that I like to hunt in the wintertime. They were warm, I stayed dry, I was happy. But I got older, then I got to pee more. There lies the problem. Now, I got a couple of my buddies that wear dry suits, and they're getting up in age like me, and they pee in their their dry suits, and wash it out when they get home. Well, I just can't do that. So I like the wetsuit. I stay nice and warm. I can pee as much as I want to. Now, you get old like me, you take kind of pills. Pills sometimes make you pee. I take a fluid pill. You talk about peeing, and in this next 3 or 4 hours, I'm probably going to pee 3 or 4 times. That's the problem with getting old. Sometimes your plumbing works good, but it works backwards sometimes, you know what I mean? You got to keep your plumbing together. Anyway, that's the reason I don't wear those other two things. And I wear this suit cut off like I showed you, because I don't like going out there to deep water where my arms got to be insulated and my neck and everything like that. So I'm going to stay in the just above my waist zone, and I'm not going really anymore. If it's cold, I'm not going. I'm just going to stay home and mess around, play with the dogs. Oh, I got some more information. I got some DNA back. Well, I didn't get the DNA back, but I don't know if you know this or not, but I think you do. Most of you do. Dottie has two sisters. One's named Lottie, and I don't remember what the other one's name is. Lottie is the identical twin, and the other dog is solid black. So the girl who owns Lottie, she wanted to know what she was, so she had a DNA test done on them. And I'll put it in the thing so you'll see what Dottie is. She's more, the DNA test says she's more Boxer and Brittany than anything else, but she has Labrador, Australian Shepherd, and a beagle in her. As the girl said, she's a Heinz 57 mutt. That's the truth. All right, stand by. We're headed almost to the cave.
Well, the water's nice and clear. I see one looter. That's all here. Stand by. The first good sound of 12:09. We dug two pieces of iron so far. High sounding iron. I don't know what this is. Whatever it is still in the hole. Three scoots later, we got it. Whatever it is. I see nothing. Stand by. .1203, I don't think it's gonna be very big. That could be it. I ain't sure that's it, but that is metal. Stand by. Got a 12:05. First scoopo. Piece of wire. Got another 12:05. Still in the hole though. See if we got any marbles in here. Nope. We got it that time though. 12:05. I think I see it. Kind of an odd looking thing. I got 12:42 this time. Still in the hole too. That's three scoops, still says 7 inches. That's four scoops. Stand by a minute. Whatever it was out. Wait a minute. Maybe it's a part of an old bracelet or something, you know it? Watch or something. Another 1205. Got a lot of 1205s today. Oh, that's a nice one. Ranch. Now that's just what I was looking for right there, I can tell you. For my lunch. This sounds really good. It sounds irony, then it sounds like it's got something in the middle of it. Stand by. Galvanized bolts that go on those things right there. You see them? I think that's what it is. You see, that's what it is right there. A lot of iron out here today. A lot of rocks. See them? Iron. Not many targets though. Damn. I dug a couple of bottle caps. Stand by. It's a beautiful day though. This look more familiar to you? Let's see how it goes. There's a nice little low spot right there. I hope it ain't full of that damn grass. I see some grass on the beach. Stand by. And only a portion of that. I don't see any grass from here. Except for the dry sand. Well, it's nice and clear around the old cave today. And no grass. Alrighty. Let's see what happens. All the sentinels are here today. You ain't gonna believe it, we got another 1205. Somehow she's got locked into 1205 mode today. Sometimes 1205 ain't too bad, but so far today is nothing but blanks. I don't see anything looks like a 1205 to me. I don't see anything. It is, it's tiny. Nothing in the hole. Must have been a false alarm of some kind. You don't get many false alarms though. That's what makes me nervous. Stand by. 11:18. Looks like aluminum to me. Yep, burnt aluminum. /13:06. Ah, it's 22. First one today. Maybe that's a good sign. Here, we dug two or three more 22s since the last time. A lot of 22s right here. I don't know what a 1233 is. I can't even expect to guess. I don't see anything. It looks like a 12 anything. Stand by, let's see if we can find it. Great, more aluminum. I should have known it. Still got it. Come out of there, baby. Yeah, we got it that time. 12:15.
I think that's a pretty thing.
I don't see it initial. Oh yeah, 12:15, just what you expect it to be. A pop top. I mean a pull tab, you know what I mean. That's what it's supposed to be, 12:15. There it is, big as life. Two steps was 12:44. We can't get it though. Don't want to come out. Come out of there, Chiquito. We got it that time. I don't see anything. It looks like a 1243. I see it's a damn penny. Well, I'll say one thing. There's some targets here anyway, for a change. You can't see it, but that's a wheat penny. There's the head. You can just make out the little doodads along the side there, you know. Well, that's a good sign, you know. Some stuff here to dig. It's close together, too. He's trying to get out of there, ain't he? You see what he's up to? He's got scared. This pull tab has scared him to death, so he's trying to get away from that pull tab. Come on out of there, boy. Done, 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 done. Better hope you don't get in your wetsuit. Third scoop. I don't know if I like it now. It might be iron. It's been 10:41 now. Four scoops off of it. We got it, whatever it was. Old sinker. I mean old too, baby. Look at that, baby. You got some stuff on her, that sinker has. 12:16. Over there, another pull tab. 22. That's the fifth of 22 I got. I don't know why that 16 came from, though. Is that part of somebody's teeth? That's what it looks like. Here comes the afternoon tsunami. It went every afternoon right here. I don't know where it comes from. Look at that. Tsunami! '43 maybe. I scratched the side of it, you can see it silver. Damn, things are picking up here in the afternoon when the tide's coming in. We just had another tsunami. Damn, double damn. I get home, I got this on my phone. That's a Mumbles man. He said, guess where I am? He's in a damn hospital bed. I guess his doctor's appointment didn't go too well. More to follow, I hope. Damn, I don't like it. Mumbles man, get out of there. Well, here's a roundup at Rancho Max. 41 quarters, the best of it. That's a cool little sinker. Somebody cut it in half to make it lighter, I guess. Some lead, more lead. This must be a dental bridge, somebody, a couple guys told me. Stand by. I don't know what this is. It looks like it could be a part of a bracelet or something. Whatever it is heavy. I had two more of those, but they fell out of my pouch. And a couple other things I was putting in my pouch. Apparently I was putting them between my pouch and my wetsuit and not in the pouch pocket. But that's the way it goes. I don't know what this is. I think it's a nail. One of them nails has got a like a washer built around it or something, you know? Either you see them. Big old spoon. Little teeny piece of lead, split shot. That's it. The boys are charging to go outside. I got to run. Daddy had a blood clot in his leg. And it broke loose and went up to his lung. So they got him in the hospital taking care of him. Said he'd be here for, he thinks, 2 days. Maybe three. I don't think I like it. I'm going to go see him tomorrow. I'll give you a better report. Okay, that's it. See you later.